There's been renewed calls for more official acknowledgement for First Nations people who died in the Frontier Wars, which began in 1788. Earlier this year, the conversation was revisited when Labor leader Anthony Albanese omitted a section of a speech at the war memorial that would have broken new ground on this issue.
Yeah, while there's been events to honour those who have fought in these wars, there's a sense among some of the members of the community that more needs to be done, not only within the Australian War Memorial, but across the country. Jodan Perry has more.
The centrepiece of Brisbane's Anzac Square, a light horseman that is a memorial to Queenslanders who fought in the Second Boer War. Also in the area, the Shrine of Remembrance and the Shrine of Memories. Across the road at the Post Office Square stands a statue of William Glasgow, a highly decorated officer who served in World War I. And behind him, at the edge of the area, is a small plaque that references Dundali, an Aboriginal resistance fighter who stood up to the might of the invading British.
He was the last publicly executed person here in Brisbane. I think it was like 1855, I believe it was.
Bo Spearham is a broadcaster at the Brisbane Indigenous Media Association.
And today we dedicate this episode to Aboriginal people who fought on the frontier.
He hosts a podcast called Frontier War Stories, and he's passionate about sharing that part of history with the community.
Originally what I wanted to do was focus on sort of the resistance, the battles, and these figures like Dundali, Pamoy, Yagan, Waliar, you know, I can go on. But talking to different people, I couldn't talk to them without sort of them or myself mentioning these massacres, you know, that happened and took place in different parts of the country. One of the reasons why I started this project was to sort of uncover the truth of what happened in this country and how we've been put in the position that we're in, the unfortunate position, and also how the dominant society has put in the very fortunate position that they're in today.
Every year on January 5th, Bo joins other community members to honour those who fought in the Frontier Wars, including Dundali. It's been estimated that 60,000 First Nations people died in frontier conflict in Queensland alone. That's similar to the amount of Australian soldiers that died in World War I. And while there is Dundali's small plaque in the CBD, Bo says more should be done to acknowledge the Aboriginal resistance in the state.
It's just the start, you know, hopefully maybe one day there can be a statue there of Dundali, or sort of a monument that, you know, respects the efforts of frontier wars throughout southeast Queensland.
On Saturday in Cairns, the Gimoi Walubara Yidinji people presented the Frontier Wars commemoration. With a mixture of dance, music, storytelling and poetry that honoured the first battles in the Gimoi tropical rainforest and coastal areas.
And the reason why it's called Skeleton Creek is because heads were put on stakes. Our old people's heads, our great-grandfathers and grandfathers' heads were put on stakes. Even the young kids' heads were put on stakes at this place.
Meanwhile, traditional owners in Tasmania have welcomed an agreement with the state branch of the RSL to create a memorial garden in the vicinity of Hobart's cenotaph, the main military monument in the state. It's been hailed as a significant moment in the country's history by historians. In February, opposition leader Anthony Albanese left out a crucial part of his speech at the Australian War Memorial that would have referenced the frontier wars.
The fight for a nation that at all times wasn't prepared to fight for them.
He told the point it was an honest mistake, and if he had the chance again, he would include that acknowledgement.
I'm certainly happy to. I've raised it in the federal parliament. I've raised it in a number of forums. We have a number of works and references towards the frontier wars at the war memorial now. There's the painting of the Ruby Plains massacre that occurred. There's also the APY lands painting, which is defending the country and culture with spears. There's an Indigenous liaison officer has been appointed at the war memorial. But we need to do more, I think. And part of what I've raised with the director of the war memorial directly is some overt recognition in some way we need to recognise that our history is one of violence in this country.
The federal government has approved a $500 million upgrade for the Australian War Memorial. The Point reached out to see if there would be a greater recognition of frontier wars at the memorial in the future. In a statement, War Memorial Director Matt Anderson said Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Fence of Country has become an increasingly important part of the memorial's storytelling. The memorial does not claim to tell this story in its entirety. There is acknowledgement of frontier violence and conflict at the memorial in the galleries, archives, programs, publications and website.
Say that, you know, it hasn't already just goes to show you the sort of the thinking and the history, the lack of knowledge that, you know, people have of Aboriginal people in this country. You know, it was last year that the Prime Minister gave $50 million to commemorate Captain Cook and his voyage to the east coast of Australia. You know, they, you know, lots of money gets sort of always pumped into sort of, you know, figures like Cook, or sort of looking at sort of other history, you know, other than ours. And it's definitely, you know, hopefully something does happen more that's more palatable, you know, and that's more true to the history of First Nations people, and especially the frontier wars in this country as well.